Hi, this is Ashutosh and welcome once again in this Indefinite Integrals course. And this is actually the last lesson of the entire course, and this is Integration by Parts, Part 2. So in the previous lesson, that is lesson number 21, we have discussed the basic stuffs of Integration by Parts and also did some questions. So here we are going to do some special kind of Integration by Parts and okay, so let's get started. So suppose we have to integrate this kind of integrand. So actually this is a special result we have to apply in this kind of integrand. So what is the kind? Actually, whenever you see the integrand of this form, that e to the power x fx and its derivative is actually written as the sum of them, and e to the power x is multiplied to it, then the answer should be e to the power x fx plus c. So you have to recognize, you have to identify the fx and its derivative, and also the both are should be in the as the sum of them. So now let us try to prove why this is that. So let's get started with the left hand side. So we have taken this e to the power x fx plus f dash x times dx, and I have simply multiplied it and split it into two integrands. So the first will be e to the power x fx dx, and the second will be e to the power x f dash x dx. I will not simply going to do anything in the second one, and here I can apply the integration by parts. And why so? Because you see that whatever with the function here, it will be in the top of this islet sequence, and it will come before e to the power x. I mean, it will be the top two e to the power x, because islet e will come at the bottom. So of course fx can be taken as the first or u. So it can be written as fx times integration of e to the power x and minus the derivative of the first, that is f dash x, and the integral of e to the power x again. And this thing I have written as it is. Now you can see that the integration of e to the power x will be e to the power x only. And we will have integration of e to the power x again here, e to the power x. And this I have written as it is. So here you can see that these two terms can be cancelled, and we will have e to the power x fx and of course a constant c. So whenever you see a function its derivative as the sum and multiplied with e to the power x as the integrand, you have to write the answer directly e to the power x fx. But first of all, we have to show that what is the function and what is its derivative while we do any question. So suppose I have the example e to the power x sine x plus cosine x. So you can see clearly that if we assume sine x as the function, its derivative derivative is cosine x, and they are written at the sum multiplied with e to the power x. So the answer of this integration will be e to the power x sine x plus c. It was actually in this example, it was easy to identify fx and f dash x, but sometimes it may be difficult or need some manipulation or transformation. So suppose I have x ln x plus 1 by overall by x. So you can see that x ln x plus 1, and of course since we need fx plus f dash x, so anyhow we want to see two terms separated with a plus sign in this bracket. And for this purpose we want to split it at least so that we can see what are the two functions we get. So here if you split it, you get the first function as ln x and the second as 1 over x, and it immediately tells us that oh, the derivative of ln x is 1 over x. So since fx is ln x and f dash x is 1 over x, so the integral will be e to the power x ln x plus c. Now let's do some more complicated thing. So here the integrand is x squared plus 1 over 1 plus x the whole squared e to the power x. So first of all we should write this e to the power x in front because we want to see this similar pattern here. And also this x squared plus 1 over 1 plus x squared is given. So we have to split into two parts, that is the function and its derivative. So we are not going to see the derivative exactly at the first sight, but at least we want to split this thing into two parts. And how can we see that? Because you know that this 1 plus x squared will appear in the second term if you split it, and this must be the derivative. So if this is derivative, it means this first term will be like that, which has x plus 1 in the denominator, because whenever you see the function which has the power 2 in denominator, it indicates that it is the derivative of that function which has power 1 in the denominator. So therefore, for this purpose, you have to cancel 1 plus x in the first part. So that what we can do, we have to cancel 1 plus x and retain 1 plus x in the denominator in the first part. And for this purpose, we need 1 plus x in the top. So we must need x squared minus 1 here in the first part. So what I have done, this x squared plus 1 can be written as x squared minus 1 plus 2. And so we can now separate it into two parts, like x plus 1, so x squared minus 1 by 1 plus x squared and 2 by 1 plus x squared. So here x squared minus 1 can be written as x plus 1 times x minus 1. And so you can see that x plus 1 and this x plus 1 will get cancelled, and we will have x minus 1 by 1 plus x squared. And now, actually, it was the guess. And let us see, let us now check whether our guess is working or not. Because now we are successful to find this 1 plus x in the first part as the denominator, and 1 plus x squared as the denominator in the second part. And that is actually we want to. So here now this can be assumed as the fx, and this must be the f dash x. So let's check it. So if you assume this fx as x minus 1 by x plus 1, if you find the derivative by using the quotient rule, of course, we will get the derivative as 2 by 1 plus x squared, 1 plus x the whole squared. It means our guess was correct, and this x minus 1 by x plus 1 should be fx. So the final integral will be e to the power x times that fx plus c, and that is the answer. Now let us see some more example. So for this example, it is what? E to the power x times x minus 4 by x minus 2 the whole cubed. So of course, now you can see that if this is x cubed and you want to separate it, you must have the first part in which the denominator has the power x power 2. So for this, you must cancel this x minus 2 somewhere for the first part. So this x minus 4 can be written as x minus 2 minus 2. And when you separate it, you will get 1 by x minus 2 the whole cube. And the second part, you will get this minus 2 by x minus 2 the whole cube. And if you see it clearly, it is plus and minus of this. And if you see this as the function fx, this must be the derivative of fx. And so that is the correct answer. You can check it. In some questions, we have, in the questions where inverse of function is involved in the integrand, we can apply the technique of integration by parts to handle such problems. Let us try to understand it. So suppose I have the integrand as sine inverse x over x squared. So what I can do that I don't want to see this this inverse. Okay. One thing I want to mention, that this can be also treated as sine inverse x times 1 over x squared. And the students can understand that, oh, this is inverse times any algebraic. So this is understood as 1 and this is 2, and we can use the integration by parts. So that is also the correct method, and students are welcome to do that. They must be appreciated for that. All right. Now, I want to convey a new method, or another method, not a new, actually it is another method, to do such kind of problem. without directly applying the indexation by parts. So here, suppose I have sine versus x over x square, so I can assume that sine versus x is theta, and of course x will be sine theta now, and dx will be cos theta d theta. So now we can substitute this thing, and we transform this into in the form of theta. So we'll have theta over sine square theta, and at the place of dx we will substitute cos theta d theta. So this sine square theta will be this is sine square theta and this is cosine theta. So we can take this cosine and cosine by sine as cot, and 1 by sine as that is cosec. So we will have theta cosec theta cot theta. Now you can see that cosec theta cot theta is a function whose integration is possible. So always assume in this technique, you always assume theta at the first and rest of the parts excluding d theta at the second. Okay, always assume theta at the first, theta at the first always, or u always, and rest of the things will be the second. So this is the technique you have to this is the way we can find the integration easily. So let us try to do further. So this is theta I have taken first, and cosec theta cot theta at the second, and you can see that this can be done by integration by part, that theta, that is the u, the integration of second, the derivative of first, and then integration of second and the whole integration. So the integration of cosec theta cot theta will be negative cosec theta, of course, and the derivative of theta is 1. And you will observe that if I say that you have to always take theta as u, so you have to always differentiate theta at this place, and you will always get 1 at this place. So you will have negative cosec theta, and again this is cosec theta. Actually the integration is about negative cosec theta, but here's a negative sign, so I can take it, I can put it positive here, removing this negative sign in front of this cosec theta, and we will now have to integrate this cosec theta. So we will integrate this cosec theta, we will get ln cosec theta minus cot theta. This is the standard result, and of course you have to write the answer in form of x. So you have substituted sine theta as x, so cosec theta will be 1 over x, and cot theta will be this form, this thing, square root of 1 over x square minus 1, because you know there's a identity of cosec theta and cot theta as 1 plus cot square theta is cosec square theta. So you know the value of cosec theta in terms of x, you can find the value of cot theta in terms of x as well, and substituting those values here you can find the write the correct answer in form of x finally. Let us apply the same technique in this example, that is tan inverse root x we have to integrate. So this time we assume this theta is tan inverse root x, and of course root x will be tan theta, and so x is equal to tan square theta. So we find the dx as 2 tan theta sec square d theta. So of course for the tan inverse root x we will substitute theta, and rest of the things should be written for dx, and that will be 2 tan theta sec square theta. Since 2 was constant, we can take outside. So this is now, and remember what I have said, we have to always take theta as first and rest of the things as second, combinedly. So I have taken theta as first, and this tan theta sec square theta combinedly taken as second. It means we are just using the formula, is u times the derivative of this minus, there will be 1 because the derivative of theta will be 1, and again tan theta sec square theta. You can assume, or you can simply observe that this will be theta, and the integration of tan theta sec square theta will be very easy, because you see that this is the function and its derivative is attached with it immediately with d theta. So you can simply see that if this is t, this is the derivative dt, and so it will be always tan square theta by 2 for this kind of integration. And here again you will get tan square theta by 2 because you are doing the same thing here itself, and that's all, and this will become 2 theta tan square theta by 2. We can cancel it also, and here this 2 and this 2 will I can cancel it, and we will have tan square theta d theta. And now you know this can be written as theta tan square theta, and this tan square theta can be done by the help of trigonometric transformation, because we can write it as sec square theta minus 1 and d theta, and now you can integrate it further to get the final answer. Let me write it again. This is tan square theta minus tan theta, and that will become plus theta plus c, and that is your answer. And you want to convert this in form of x. It is easy to convert because you know the value of tan square theta is x, you know the value of theta is tan inverse x, you know the value of tan theta is root x, and you know the value of theta is again tan inverse root x. So you don't have to transform actually in other form. So that is the answer. All right, so you understood that integration by parts can be also used in this kind of question. So that's all for today's lesson, and also that's all for the all the course. So thanks for watching the course. I hope you enjoyed the course. If any problem you find or anything I have missed in preparing this course or not included in this course, I welcome your suggestion, and your comment will be appreciated. Thanks for watching.